Holley's Terminator EFI is a self-learning fuel injection system designed to retrofit onto any carbureted engine with a 4150 mating flange to make it run like a modern engine. By adding a throttle body with fuel injectors plus an ECU and a host of sensors, the system can monitor itself and make adjustments on the fly, just like a factory fuel-injected vehicle. Step 1 is to find a suitable place to mount an O2 sensor, which will feed back the air-fuel ratio, AFR, to the ECU. Really not difficult at all with the right tools. If you don't have access to a welder, this is a simple job for a muffler shop or fabricator and shouldn't cost much at all. Step 2 is replacing the fuel pump block off plate with a much nicer version provided by Holley. Typically, you would be removing the stock mechanical fuel pump from this location on the engine block since you're installing a high pressure electric pump for the EFI system. Next, I turn my attention to the factory quadrajet carburetor. In addition to the fuel injection system, Holley also sent a Y-Install dual plane intake manifold. This is one area where the big Chevy engine could definitely use some improvement, with the dual plane design and long runners adding low end torque. Swapping the intake manifold required removing the distributor, so I took the time to label all the plug wires before removing them. Look at what a mess the stock manifold was. Side by side, you can really see the differences between the manifolds. Look at the length of those runners. That stock cast iron manifold was so heavy I had to climb up into the engine bay and muscle it out. I was glad to be replacing it with a much lighter aluminum part. I stuffed rags in the valley and ports before cleaning everything up and chasing the threads. It's important to wash a new cast part like this and inspect it as you go. You're looking for any metal shavings or dust, and hand washing it with dish soap really makes you pay attention to all the surfaces. I wire brushed out the ports the best I could, then blew it out with compressed air. New felt pro gaskets were positioned before I dropped the new stealth manifold into place. I was feeling much better having gone through this part of the motor now. ARP was kind enough to send over a complete bolt kit for my engine, so I already had brand new quality hardware to use for the install. I torqued all of the bolts down in the correct sequence. I knew I was getting close to installing the heart of the system when I threaded in the throttle body mounting studs. The Terminator EFI system uses a standard 4154 BBL mounting pattern, so it will bolt right up to the old school Y-in manifold. Before I dropped the throttle body over the studs, I had to check it out on the bench. Everything is pre-terminated, so all you have to do is connect one plug and the fuel supply and return lines. The throttle body's air entry is a very similar design to that used in NASCAR, making this some serious trickle-down technology for a DIYer. I mentioned that the throttle body itself houses most of the necessary sensors, which makes this plug and play. One distinct advantage of the Holley system though is the use of commonly available sensors that you'll recognize from looking at a modern fuel-injected engine. Check out the annular discharge rings on the bottom side. These allow for maximum flow and optimum fuel atomization. Just imagine the fuel misting in a perfect ring and completely filling each barrel. After checking out all the trick features of the Terminator EFI throttle body, I dropped it over the four studs and torqued it down. I routed the throttle cable and installed the springs, which were now nice and clean. Now that most of the underhood work was complete, I turned my attention to the ECU and wiring harness. Thankfully, everything was very clearly labeled. Although each plug was unique and would only fit into the corresponding plug or sensor, it still helps to know what you're working on and where it is goes. Almost there, just the fuel pressure regulator and high pressure pump left to install. High quality Earl's fittings were included, which saved the extra expense and a trip to the parts store. I installed the high-pressure fuel pump on the frame rail back by the tank, along with the provided pre- and post-fuel filters. mount the LCD touchscreen display in the perfect spot on my gauge cluster. Once I powered up the system, I answered a few questions such as engine size and cam type, and an initial tune was loaded. From here it will self-learn by simply driving around, and it's already adapting with each passing mile. The idle is smooth and throttle response gets better every time I drive it. From light to full throttle, it's working things out and providing instant power. This Holley Terminator EFI setup is really going to dial in the way the engine runs, while also giving me a ton more insight into what the engine is actually doing. I can now monitor RPM, AFR, IAT, MAP, coolant temp, and many other parameters that the ECU is reading, and also customize the screen to show only the gauges I want to see. Thanks for watching this video, and remember to subscribe.